ओके, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू सी द प्रोसेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. इफ द मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंक्स और ए कट बाय द कंडक्टर विच इज वेरीज और ए चेंजेस, देन एन ईएमएफ इंड्यूस्ड इन टू दैट कंडक्टर इज कॉल्ड एज द प्रोसेस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. ओके, सो इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन इज द प्रोसेस. एंड वॉट इज दैट प्रोसेस? इफ ए मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स लिंकिंग टू द कंडक्टर विच इज वेरिंग इन नेचर, ओके, ड्यू टू द लिंकिंग ऑफ दैट वेरिंग नेचर मैग्नेटिक फ्लक्स टू द कंडक्टर एंड ईएमएफ इंड्यूस्ड इन टू दैट कंडक्टर, दैट प्रोसेस इज कॉल्ड एज द इलेक्ट्रोमैग्नेटिक इंडक्शन. सो यू कैन सी इन द फिगर ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड देर इज अ कॉयल और ए लूप एंड विच इज स्टेशनरी इन नेचर, एंड देर इज वन मूवेबल मैग्नेट विच इज ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड. ओके, एंड डायरेक्शन ऑफ मूवमेंट इज गिवन ऑन द टॉप ऑफ दैट मैग्नेट. ओके, सो विच कैन बी मूव्ड ऑन ए लेफ्ट एंड राइट हैंड साइड. ओके, सो ऑन ए लेफ्ट हैंड साइड, ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड, लेफ्ट राइट इन दैट नेचर. ओके, इफ यू मूव दैट मैग्नेट ऑन द लेफ्ट हैंड साइड इट कम क्लोजर टू द कॉयल, एंड इफ यू मूव दैट मैग्नेट ऑन द राइट हैंड साइड इट गोज अवे फ्रॉम द लूप और ए कॉयल. ओके, सो द ड्यू टू द मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट कॉयल, नॉट कॉयल, ड्यू टू द मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट मैग्नेट द ईएमएफ जनरेटेड, नॉट ईएमएफ, द ड्यू टू द मूवमेंट ऑफ दैट मैग्नेट फ्लक्स जनरेटेड बाय द मैग्नेट विच इज लिंकिंग टू द कॉयल चेंजेस विथ रिस्पेक्ट टू द टाइम. ओके, सो यू कैन इमेजिन देर इज ए वन कॉयल एंड इन फ्रंट ऑफ इट देर इज अ मैग्नेट एंड वी आर मूविंग दैट मैग्नेट नियर टू दैट कॉयल. ओके, towards the coil, away from the coil, towards the coil, away from the coil, due to the movement of that coil, due to the movement of that magnet near that coil, the flux generated from that magnet which is linking to the coil also changes due to the movement of that magnet. Okay, so due to the changing flux or due to the varying flux linking to that coil, an EMF induced into that conductor or EMF induced into that coil which is called as the process of electromagnetic induction. Okay, so in simple terms you can remember it as a if the flux which is varying in nature or if the flux which is changing in nature linked to the any conductor, EMF induced into that conductor, that process is called as the electromagnetic induction. So regarding this electromagnetic induction, there are two laws, Faraday's first law and Faraday's second law. So what is Faraday's first law of electromagnetic induction? Whenever a conductor is placed in a varying magnetic field, an electromotive force is induced. So same sentence or same concept is explained here, okay, but in different words. Okay, so whenever a conductor is placed in a varying magnetic field, an EMF induced into that conductor, which is called as the Faraday's first law. So you can see in the diagram, there is a two poles, north pole and south pole. Okay, and one rotating coil is placed in between them. Okay, so the coil is placed in the magnetic flux or magnetic field. Okay, so as the coil is rotational in nature, if the coil starts rotating, the flux cut by that coil also changes or varies with respect to the time. Okay, so the varying flux is cut by that coil and EMF induced into that coil, that process is called as the Faraday's first law. Okay, so Faraday's first law is very simple. Whenever a conductor is placed in a varying magnetic field, EMF induced into that conductor. Let us understand Faraday's second law. The EMF induced into that coil which is equal to the rate of change of flux linkage. Okay, so the amount of EMF induced into that coil, okay, which is depends on the rate of change of flux linkage. Okay, so how fast the flux is changing, okay, which is linking to that coil, okay, depends on which there is a EMF induced into that coil. Okay, so if the coil is rotating very fast, okay, the flux linked to with that coil changes with respect to time very fast. Okay, so as the rate of change of flux linkage is very fast, the EMF induced into that coil is very high. Okay, so the induced EMF into that in conductor depends on the rate of change of flux linkage. As the rate of change of flux linkage is very high, induced EMF into that conductor is also very high. Okay, so its equation becomes E is equal to N d phi by dt. N is the number of turns of the coil and d phi dt is the rate of change of flux linkage. So equation for the induced EMF, E is equal to N d phi by dt. Okay, then Fleming's right hand rule. So Fleming's right hand rule used to obtain the direction of induced EMF. So as we know, the induced EMF EMF induced into that coil. Okay, so we can determine the direction of induced EMF into that coil with the help of Fleming's right hand rule. So you can see the right hand shown in the figure. Okay, and first three fingers, thumb, first finger and middle finger, are keep perpendicular to each other. And you can see in the figure, thumb indicates the direction of the motion of the conductor. First finger indicates the direction of the magnetic field or direction of the motion of the magnetic flux lines, direction of the magnetic flux lines. Then the middle finger indicates the direction of conductor, direction of the current. Okay, so which is called as the Fleming's right hand rule. So what is Fleming's right hand rule? If we keep first three fingers of the right hand perpendicular to each other, those fingers are thumb, first finger and middle finger. Okay, and if the thumb indicates the direction of motion of the conductor, first finger indicates the direction of the magnetic flux lines, then the middle finger indicates the direction of current, which is called as the Fleming's right hand rule. Okay, so with the help of Fleming's right hand rule, we can determine the direction of current. So to identify or determine the direction of current, we should know the direction of motion of the conductor and as well as the direction of flux lines. If we know these two things, we can determine the direction of the current. Okay, so with this we are going to stop here. Thank you.